Kiran Bedi began her road show by paying tribute to freedom fighter Lala Lajpat Rai, but that gesture has now snowballed into a huge controversy. Kejriwal now taking aim at Bedi after she garlanded the statue with a BJP scarf. The Aam Aadmi Party taking aim at the BJP's chief ministerial candidate and saying, "Don't saffronize freedom fighters."
लाला लाजपत राय की मूर्ति को मफलर पहनाया किरण बेदी ने, बीजेपी का जो मफलर है वो पहनाया गया है।
ठीक नहीं है, अपने स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों ने पूरे 120 करोड़ लोगों के लिए, पूरे देश के लिए, देश को आजाद कराने के लिए लड़ाई लड़ी थी, वहाँ हमें राजनीति नहीं करनी चाहिए। अपने स्वतंत्रता सेनानियों के वो तो स्वतंत्रता, लाला लाजपत राय तो आम आदमी पार्टी, कांग्रेस, बीजेपी, सब लोगों के हैं, हमारे सबके दिलों में बसे हुए हैं। उसको पार्टीबाजी में नहीं उलझाना चाहिए।
The first big controversy really that Arvind Kejriwal picked on after filing his nomination papers, of course, was Kiran Bedi garlanding the statue of Lala Lajpat Rai.
Yes, in fact, even some people in the Aam Aadmi Party are wondering if that's a controversy that is maybe not big enough to be blown up. Saurabh Bhardwaj, who is the candidate of the Aam Aadmi Party from the GK constituency, incidentally, he's pitted against the president's daughter, Shamisha Mukherjee. He's live with us right now. He just filed his nomination paper. Saurabh, what do you make of this entire controversy? Do you think that what was done by Kiran Bedi was wrong, and why do you think that?
I have just heard it from sources. Probably it is a buzz that she they used some BJP flag or something around Lala Lajpat Rai's neck. So if it was done deliberately, then it's a wrong thing. And if it was done just out of confusion and all those things, then we can excuse them.
But she was just saying that it's a way of paying respect to a historical figure, someone who is so important in India's political history. What's wrong with it? It wasn't meant to deface or defile the image of Lala Lajpat Rai in any way.
I don't think, Lala Lajpat Rai ever associated himself with BJP or RSS, and now he's no more also. So if somebody is no more and somebody is a national figure and you want them to be associated to a particular party with which they were never associated when they were alive, so I think it's a stupidity.
But why is it stupidity? He's a national figure. He doesn't belong to any political party. He's a national political figure to be revered by everyone. So why should any one political party be able to appropriate his legacy? And why shouldn't the other party not pay respects to him?
Yeah, there's a way of paying respect. But you are putting your own party flag around the neck of a national figure who is no more. So I think it is unnecessarily you are trying to associate that figure with your party, and which is totally untrue. So this is, you are trying to manipulate people, and that too with a person who was a big national figure and who is no more. Had he been alive, you could have, tried all your tactics, tricks on him. But he is no more, and he is respected across India. So you shouldn't associate or force that person post humorous to be associated with the party.
Okay, so you're saying this is a sort of political trick, but now I want to ask you specifically about your constituency. You, of course, have Shamishtha Mukherjee from the Congress to go up against, and then the BJP, which says that now the middle class, which of course makes up middle class and upper middle class, which makes up a large part of your constituency, is going to gravitate towards the BJP. They claim to have very strong support from this particular constituency. What do you think is going to be a bigger challenge, the Congress or the BJP?
I think middle class or upper middle class, everybody votes, according to some logic. And there is no logic left why people in Delhi should vote for BJP. They have seen our rule of 49 days and seen a lot of changes on ground, especially related to corruption of MCD, police and other things. They have seen the rule of BJP directly and indirectly in Delhi as well as center for last 7-8 months.
Okay, but final question to you. When we saw Mr. Kejriwal coming in here earlier to file his nomination, there was loud sloganeering between the BJP and Aam Aadmi Party. Is this going to be the trend till the time that Delhi finally votes, that it's going to be a vicious, eyeball to eyeball battle between the Aam Aadmi Party, literally like street fights between the two parties? Because wherever the two parties come face to face, this seems to be the trend.
I think we as politicians should try not to get into all these things. And I would like to, address everybody in Aam Aadmi Party that, even if BJP people do this, you should not respond.
Okay. we're hoping that your cadre will listen to that. Thank you very much, Saurabh Bhardwaj, for speaking two times now. That was the Aam Aadmi Party's candidate from the Greater Kailash constituency. But remember, this is an issue which the Aam Aadmi Party says was partisan on the part of the BJP, Lala Lajpat Rai issue. Some people thinking it's being blown out of proportion. But should his legacy be appropriated by any one party? The Aam Aadmi Party doesn't think so.